runs it like
Did you know of your friend, Chase, before you met him?
You mean before we killed Bomb's men and brought Chase back to the agency with us?
No, before you stopped our untrained soldiers from succeeding in their mission.
What would happen if I said yes?
What would happen if you lied? Now for a question that does not pertain to Chase. What does Alastar know about Sabrina and her mind control?
Alright.
Then which of your friends would you rather see killed because of your lack of answers?
Good luck. If you try and kill Kai, he will undoubtedly turn into your worst nightmare. Catching Alaine would be like chasing a dog with a bone. And when you finally catch up to that dog and try to take its bone, it will tear you to shreds. Toshiro? Well, you can't touch him because he's always on the lookout and he'll spot you from a mile away. As for Chase, I have a feeling he isn't going to be easy to kill. And killing me? Go ahead and try.
It doesn't seem like anyone is here. Did they all die?
Most of them were evacuated and moved to safety. Not many people stayed behind after our agents informed them of the attack.
If most of them left, why are we here?
Mainly we're tricking on the people who chose not to leave, who didn't heed our warnings. Our job is to make sure that none of them are in need of help.
What's wrong, Ash? I hear something. Something from over there. Watch your balance. Any one of these boards can break. Got it. Be careful, Ash.
Don't hurt me, please.
It's okay, we're not here to hurt you. Alaine, where's Toshiro?
He stayed up there in case we needed help. If we called, he would go get Master Alastar and Master Foalias.
Could you go get Toshiro? Instead of having him get the other agents who won't fit down here, tell him to come down and help us. We might be able to get the kid out if we all try.
Can you speak?
Can you tell us if anyone else is in here?
They're gone now.
Who was in here? Who left?
Guys, I need to talk to you about something important.
Okay, go ahead. I'm all ears.
What is it, Chase?
Okay, so I have something kind of like a confession to make. I have a strong feeling why Bomb would want to kidnap me.
Go on.
I know this will come as a huge surprise, but what I say is completely true. I have been keeping something from you four since the day you found me. A big secret. I find it really ironic, but when Master Raoul was telling us about the mind control business and how Bomb has someone with that ability, well, the only reason I knew anything about it was because I sort of have the same thing.
You have mind control? And you've known this for how long?
Since I was a kid. I haven't really ever told anybody about it because I didn't see the need to make people dislike me for something I can't change.
And having that sort of power seems to make others think that I would use it against them, that I would purposefully hurt them with it, but that isn't the case. I never wanted to hurt anybody. That's why I didn't socialize with people, not even my friendly neighbors. And I felt like telling y'all would hurt you because you'd now have more of a reason to try and protect me, which meant putting you in more danger. But I've done that without telling you, and now look where we are.
Did you know that Bomb was trying to capture you for your ability before we brought you here?
No, I didn't even know someone like Bomb existed. I thought that if I told no one, it wouldn't make a difference.
Bomb has his ways of getting knowledge.
Are you able to use this power? Like, do you know how to use it?
In my whole life, I haven't tried using it more than a handful of times. And even then, it was only for the smallest things, and that was a long time ago, so I have no clue.
How could you test it on someone?
There are levels of mind control usage. To put it simply, we're going to use 3 levels. If you use the low amount of control, it won't harm the person, and you'll be able to control the movement of their body. Level 2 is somewhere in between 1 and 3. A little stronger than 1, but not as harsh as 3. You're able to control their body and their mind. If you use level 3 of mind manipulation, you can control their entire body, their mind, and cause immense pain. The person has no independent thoughts and no possible way to deny orders they're given. As for above that...
You mean it goes beyond those 3 levels? Man, I don't want to meet up with someone who has mind control and is trying to kill me.
If you go higher than 3, you can kill a person with nothing more than your thoughts. But you'd have to be extremely skilled to master levels above 3.
I take it that means you can't?
I couldn't even get close. And Bomb supposedly has a person with mind control at his base. He also has Ash.
Alright then! We either leave tomorrow afternoon or evening. Wait, shouldn't we tell Master Alastar of Chase's ability? Or take time to really think about going there without any backup? What if we left a note for them to find? To come after us? That way we won't be completely defenseless if something goes wrong.
Do we really need them to follow us? They'll just insist we stay! Actually, Toshiro is right. We should message them through the phone when we get to Bomb's base. It'll be too late for them to stop us, but they can at least send help if we need.
Dog, I was hoping we could do this like a secret mission or something, without the leaders knowing a thing.
And get killed? Yeah, brilliant idea, Kai.
Come on, guys. It's late. We should all go to bed if we're gonna rescue Ash tomorrow.
But if we stayed up for a few more hours, we wouldn't have to go to sleep. Before long, it will be 4:00. Time to rise and shine.
No kidding. I still don't see why y'all wake up at such absurd hours of the morning.
You mean us. Not just me, Alaine, Ash, and Toshiro. You're part of us, too.
With you, I'd wish that